The Penobscot natives, who once inhabited this wilderness, told stories of Mount Katahdin as though it were a person. Their tale, still alive today, spoke of the spirit of the mountain, the benevolent earth god who protected the tribe and its people. They also told stories about the demon Pamola, who haunted Katahdin, concealed in the fog and cold mist of the summit. One who fell into his grasp endured great trials of the spirit and body, and was sometimes lost forever.
Christmas, it's cold up here.
Should wait till winter. The wind will make your eyes tear up, tears will freeze right on your face.
We're gonna leave soon, right?
Gotta wait for Reverend Austin.
Okay. What's taking him so long?
I don't know. He went up over the crest. He should be back in any minute.
I'm getting really cold, Henry. I think I'm gonna go back and wait with my dad.
I don't know. Look how the fog's coming in fast over there. We're gonna be covered in a minute. Yeah, I think we should wait and all go back together.
I'll be fine. Bye, Henry.
Hey, Donn, watch out for the rocks. They're slippery.
Dad? Henry? Dad? Dad?
that far off the trail. I'm still on the plateau of the mountain. Follow inclines down to reach running water. Water leads to other water. Okay. Raisins! Oh, I was eating them the whole way up. Ah, Christmas! That's a fix. All right. Dear God, thank you for all my blessings. Please help all the less fortunate than I am. Henry! Here I am! Henry! Henry, don't let him! Don't let him hypnotize you, Henry!
Don't let him! Don't let him hypnotize you! Look at me!
Look at me! Dear God, please help me. Don't let Mom and Dad worry. And bring me food, because I need it soon. Amen. Hello? Hello?
Stay there. Stay there, wait. I'm coming.
In the summer of 1939, I survived more than a week lost in the wilderness around Mount Katahdin. On the afternoon of the ninth day, I crawled out of a pond on the east branch of the Penobscot River. I had lost 24 pounds and the tip of one of my toes. I had rheumatism in all my limbs and infected insect bites all over my body. There are those who attribute my survival to God. Some say I wouldn't have lived without my Boy Scout training. I agree with all of them, but I suspect, as in the stories of the Penobscot people, that the mountain itself had something to do with it. I've been back to Mount Katahdin a number of times, and every time it feels like I've shared with it a very special secret. It's something more powerful than the scrapes from rocks, or the drenching needles of rain in my bones, or the draping fog that turned me around on the plateau. It too is a living legend of Katahdin.
Loneliness is like a cancer. It starts out small and then it eats you whole. It's a creeping infestation, it's a mental complication, it's out of control. And in the hearts of men and women, desire burns just like a flame. They want something so badly, but what exactly they can't say. Loneliness versus desire in the plumes of